Hello my dear students, welcome for today's video lecture of maths. In today's lecture we are going to learn the next concept in the chapter fraction. Yesterday we have learned about the addition of fraction, how to do the addition of fraction, in which we have learned two types of addition. Addition of two types of fraction when denominators are same, and addition of fraction when denominators are not same. Okay, and we have seen that to do the addition of fraction, that is addition of numerators, the denominators of the given fractions must be equal. Okay, and if the denominators are not equal, then we have to make the denominators equal by finding their LCM and making denominators equal to the LCM, that we have seen yesterday. Same rules are applicable for the subtraction of fraction, same rules, just instead of addition we will do subtraction of the numerators. Okay, denominators must be equal. If denominators are not equal, then we will make denominators equal by finding their LCM. Okay, so see here, subtract the following, practice 5.12, subtract the following. First one is subtract 3 upon 8 from 7 upon 8. See the question, how the question is asked. We have to subtract this from this. When we say subtract 5 from 10, then how we write that? 5 minus 10 or 10 minus 5? How do we write that? In this way. When the question is given, subtract 5 from 10, means from 10 we have to subtract 5. So this 10 should be written first, and after that from 10 we have to subtract 5. Okay, so it will be like this, 10 minus 5, not 5 minus 10. Okay, similarly here, subtract 3 upon 8 from 7 upon 8, that means it, how it will be written? 7 upon 8 minus 3 upon 8. Understood? Now see, their denominators are equal. Their denominators are equal. So take each common and subtract their numerator, 7 minus 3. And you know 7 minus 3 is 4 upon 8. Here we got answer 4 upon 8. Now check, can we find reduced term of 4 upon 8? Okay, in fraction these are some basics which we have to follow, that if any fraction, if we can find reduced term of any fraction, we have to find that. Okay, so see, 4 upon 4 and 8, numerator is 4 and denominator is 8. Are they divisible by any common number, or are they in table of any same number? Yes, they are. Which? Both 4 and 8 are in table of 4, correct? So let's divide both the numerator and denominator by 4. So 4 ones are 4 and 4 twos are 8. Final answer is 1 by 2. Understood? Next, subtract 4 upon 7 from 6 upon 7. Okay? Means what? From this 6 upon 7, we have to subtract 4 upon 7. So 6 upon 7 write first, and from this subtract 4 upon 7. Again, denominators are same, so take it common and subtract their numerator, 6 minus 4. So 6 minus 4 is 2 upon 7. Can we find a reduced term of this? No, we can't, because both 2 and 7 are not in any same table. Okay? So this is your final answer. This is only the reduced term. The next, subtract 2 upon 9 from 5 upon 9. Okay? So from 5 upon 9, number written for after from, that write first, that is greater, minus 2 upon 9. Okay, then now see, the denominators are equal, so take it common, subtract the numerators. Now see, 5 minus 2 is 3 upon, denominator is 9. Okay, now think that, can we find reduced term of this 3 upon 9? Are 3 and 9 in any same table? Yes, they are which? They are in table of 3. So divide both numerator and denominator by 3. So you know 3 ones are 3, 3 threes are 9. 1/3, 1 upon 3 is the final answer. Next, subtract 5 upon 10 from 7 upon 10. So which fraction should be written first, 5 upon 10 or 7 upon 10? Yes, 7 upon 10, because we have to subtract 5 upon 10 from 7 upon 10. So 7 upon 10 should be written first, minus 5 upon 10. Okay? Denominator is same, 10, 10. So take it common and subtract the numerators. 7 minus 5 is 2 upon 10. Subtraction term, now reduce term. Smallest term. Are they in any same table, 2 and 10? In which table they are? They are in table of 2. So, let's divide both numerator and denominator by 2. 2 ones are 2, 2 fives are 10. 1 upon 5 is the final answer. Okay. Next, 5 upon 11 from 8 upon 11. So, 8 upon 11 minus 5 upon 11. Take denominator common, it is same, denominators are same, take it common. Subtract 8 numerators, that is 8 minus 5, 3 upon 11. Can we find its reduced term, smallest term, by dividing by any same number? No, we cannot, this is only the reduced term. Okay, so now pause this video, write these all examples in your notebook. After that, we will see the second question. See the second question. Subtract the following. Instruction is same. Okay? Here, if you observe these fractions, their denominators are not same. So, when denominators are not same, we cannot subtract directly the numerators. We have to do some changes. And you know what we do? We find the LCM of denominators to make their denominators same. Okay? That procedure we have to follow. Now see, first step will be same, 4 upon 9 from 5 upon 6. So 5 upon 6 minus 4 upon 9. Now denominators are not same, but we have to make them same. So we need to find LCM of 6 and 9. Can you tell me LCM of 6 and 9? What to do? How I said yesterday, when two numbers are given, in that greater number is 9, okay? Write table of 9. Start writing table of 9. 9 ones are 9. Now check, is the 9 in table of 6? 6 ones are 6, 6 twos are 12. No. Then 9 twos are 18. Is there 18 in table of 6? 6 ones are 6, 6 twos are 12, 6 threes are 18. Yes, it is there. So the LCM of 9 and 6 is 6 and 9 is 18. Understood? So once we got LCM, then what we have to do? We have to convert denominators into equal to the LCM. That is, here we have to change denominator of each fraction into 18. Okay, now your denominator is 6. We have to convert it into 18. Then by which number we need to multiply 6? 6 1 is 6, 6 2 is 12, 6 3 is 18, okay? To get here 18, we need to multiply 6 by 3, okay? And according to the principles or laws, rules of fraction, if we are multiplying in the denominator by any numbers, by same number, we need to multiply in the numerator also, okay? Minus 4 upon 9. Now 9, we have to change into 18. Then by which number we need to multiply to 9? 9 2s are 18, so here also 4 2s are 18. Okay. Now see. Pay attention very carefully. 5 3s are 15 upon 6 3s are 18 minus 4 2s are 8 upon 9 2s are 18. Okay. Now denominators are same. Now subtract the new numerators which we have got. Denominator take common is equal to, here we write 15 minus 8 is 7 upon 18. Can we find lowest term of 7 upon 18? Are 7 and 18 are in any same table? No. So this is only the lowest term. Okay, 7 upon 18. This is our answer. Understood? Next. 1 upon 3 from 2 upon 5. Subtract 1 upon 3 from 2 upon 5. So first we'll write in the form of subtraction 2 upon 5. 2 upon 5 will come first. Minus 1 upon 3. Okay, now denominators are not same. Since denominators are not same, we cannot subtract their numerators. First we will make denominators same, and for that same we will find the LCM of the denominators 5 and 3. So can you tell me orally what will be the LCM of 5 and 3? Now see, 5 and 3, greater number is 5. So write table of 5. 5 ones are 5. Is there 5 in table of 3? No. Then 5 twos are 10. Is there 10 in table of 3? No. 5 threes are 15. Is there 15 in table of 3? 3 fives are 15, yes, right? So 15 is the LCM of 5 and 3. Okay? So LCM is 15, that means we have to make the denominators equal to 15. So first fraction is 2 upon 5. Your denominator is 5. To convert 5 into 15, by which number we need to multiply 5? 5 threes are. So here also in the numerator also 5 threes are. This is the rule of fraction. Minus 1 upon 3. Here there is denominator 3. To convert 3 into 15, we need to multiply 3 by 5. 3 5s are 15. So here also 3 5s are. Okay. Now 2 threes are 6 upon 15. Minus 5 1s are 5 upon 15. Now denominator is same. Take it common. 6 minus 5. 1 upon 15. This is the lowest term. And this is the answer. Okay. Next. See, procedure of addition of fraction and subtraction of fraction is same. Okay. 7 upon 8 minus 2 upon 7. So denominators are not same. Let's find the LCM of 8 and 7. What it is? Yesterday we have found LCM of 8 and 7. What is that? 56. So 56 is the smallest number, lowest common multiple of 8 and 7. Okay. Now let's make the denominator same. 7 upon 8. Your denominator is 8. We have to convert it to 56. Then by which number we will multiply 8? 8. 7 is 56. So here also multiply by 7. Minus 2 upon 7. 7 8s are. So here multiply by 8. So here also in the numerator also, let's multiply it by 8. Okay. 7 7s are 49 upon 8 7s are 56. Minus 2 8s are 16 upon 7 8s are 56. Now denominators are same. Take it common. And numerator, subtract the numerators. 49 minus 16. Okay. So when you subtract 16 from 49, what you will get? 9 minus 6, 3. 4 minus 1, 3. 33 upon 56. Understood? Now see, are 33 and 56 in any same table, any common table? No, this is only the final answer. Okay. Last two examples. See here. Subtract 1 whole 3 upon 7 from 2 whole 5 upon 8. They are mixed fraction. Let's first write them. 2 whole 5 upon 8. Number written after from. That write first. Minus 1 whole 3 upon 7. So see, remember these are mixed fractions. So whenever we are going to add or subtract the mixed fraction, what we do first? First, we have to convert them into improper fraction. Okay? So see how we convert into improper fraction. Whole multiplied by denominator, 2 multiplied by 8 plus 5, 2 multiplied by 8 plus 5 upon denominator 8 minus, here also same, whole, that is 1 multiplied by 7 plus numerator 3 upon denominator is equal to 8 2's are 16, 16 plus 5, 21 upon 8 minus 7 1's are 7 plus 3, 10 upon 7. Okay. Now see the denominators are not same. So let's find the LCM of 8 and 7, which we have already found in the previous example. See here. 8 and 7. What is it? 56. So we will make the denominator equal to 56. 21 upon 8. 8 multiplied by how many? 56? 7. So here also multiplied by 7 minus 10 upon 7, that is 7 into 8, 56. So multiplied by 8 in the numerator also. Okay. Is equal to 21 sevens are 147. Okay. Upon 8 sevens are 56. Minus 10 eights are 80 upon 56. So now denominators are same. Let's subtract their numerators. Denominator take common, 147 minus 80 is equal to 7 minus 6 upon 56. So 67 upon 56 is the answer. Okay. So I hope you have understood this. Last example in this question, try yourself. Okay, practice yourself. If you are not able to solve, ask me. But first, you try. Try to solve this. Okay, first, these are also mixed fraction. Convert them into improper fraction. And then make the denominator same and subtract. Okay, so I hope you have understood this. Thank you for today and have a nice day.